They lead by their own examples, by how they live their everyday life, how they treat the people they interact with.
It's a special thing. You can see it in pictures, you can see it in functions when they're together. There's a true love there that just seems as if they met that morning. It's something to behold.
It was incredible. Tufts became just another great neighborhood in Somerville, rather than this institution on the other side of the fence.
Larry and Adele, in so many ways, have, you know, transformed the university, certainly encouraged cross-campus collaboration. Not just collaboration, but interaction. It's wonderful.
And the relationship, the friendships with the students, I've never seen it to the degree that I've seen it in the last 10 years. Both he and Adele are involved at all of the students' events.
To me, it's been remarkable because the university has grown, developed, earned a higher reputation during their tenure, and at the same time, it's maintained the openness, the family feel, that entrepreneurial spirit that people feel inspired by.
They're such a dynamic duo. They don't act like these distant administrators. I do feel like they personally care. Like, that's never been a question for me.
And you can yell across campus and say, "Hey, Larry," and when you see Adele, you can say, "Hey, Adele." There's something cool to that. They were a complete team.
I don't think there's many universities where you see a tandem like that, that is focused on leading a campus together.
That's just kind of who they are, just very much a part of the community, sort of leading by being part of the people.
They haven't forgotten that they are people like everybody else. Every event that we have here at Gifford House, they will thank everybody for the wonderful job, the dishwasher to the catering manager.
Inviting every undergraduate in their senior year to have dinner with him and Adele at Gifford House, sort of very parent-like and very family-oriented, and that's such a smart way to build community and a long-lasting community.
He set the standard for what the relationship would be between the community and the university. You know, I've had the opportunity to serve with three presidents. Larry is the greatest of the greatest. He not only understood education, but he also understood community.
That doesn't happen at every school where the president and his wife are so involved, and involved not just in a professional administrative way, but in a real personal way, caring about the students and the faculty and being around the students and faculty.
I was actually beginning to think about retiring. And Larry and Jamshed made such a dynamic team that I didn't want to. I thought, oh, I'm going to hang around. This is going to be good. So he's squeezed about 8 years more Tufts career out of me than I was contemplating at the time that he got in.
Larry has set the tone for the connection between diversity and excellence, and how an institution cannot pursue excellence without ensuring that it's also diverse and vibrant.
The level at which there is an interaction between the leadership of the university, the staff, and the students has been very tight, very inclusive. The university as a whole has trusted in what the leadership had in mind for the university and its ability to execute its plan.
He has really put the you in university, how someone can have a vision, develop a team around him, communicate that vision, recruit outstanding people, all while keeping true to himself.
Every time I walk down the street, I think of Larry Bacow because my feet still hurt from the 2008 marathon. As a municipal official, there's no greater partner you can have as Tufts and as someone leading it like Larry Bacow.
He's been a tireless intellectual cheerleader for the university and taken us to a next level that I don't think we could suffer ourselves.
One of the things he's been so good about doing for Tufts as a university is keeping sight of that larger picture and how he really is able to sort of prioritize the different things that he needs to do in his job. It's just inspiring.
It's very unusual to find faculty, staff, et cetera, that are so supportive and consistent about their positive attitude about a president. I just don't see that most places.
Larry always said they asked him to be president in order to get Adele because she's been such a wonderful first lady. She's such an integral part of Larry's whole presidency. You know, she really is the love of his life. I mean, she's the most important person in the world to Larry. I mean, you can't say Larry without Adele. Larry and Adele, they're like one person.
And they give credit to each other. Larry wouldn't be who he is today without Adele. They love that mutual respect. They are so sincere and genuine with their helping everyone become better at what they do at Tufts University.
I think of couples that are beshert, you know, meant for one another, and they fill the bill. Any experience where I've been with both of them, I've enjoyed.
To have the rigor of the research and the academic standards elevate while maintaining that personal connection and commitment to honoring us all as human beings, to me is pretty remarkable. I can't imagine that happening at a lot of other places. And I'm so proud of the excellence at Tufts.
As it is now obvious, Larry and Adele Bacow need precious little introduction. They have graced the Tufts community with their presence for a decade. Larry and Adele's energy, enthusiasm, and commitment are legendary because simply no single individual in Tufts history has had a greater or more positive impact than Larry Bacow.
They are such a unique couple.
And they are caring. And they are
genuine.
Gifted.
Warm.
Engaging.
Remarkable.
Fun.
Super competent.
They are definitely a team.
Approachable.
Charming.
Enthusiastic.
Generous.
Charismatic.
Inspiring.
Marvelous.
They're going to be greatly missed, but their influence is going to be felt for a long time.